Hello and welcome everyone. If you want to know how I made this beautiful painting with leftover paints, then keep on watching. Please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, it's much appreciated. I'm using the same leftover paints from last video, so I'm showing a clip from last video. I will leave all the paints, colors and brands down in the description below. Some paints were mixed with the action pouring medium, some paints were mixed with the Floetrol, so it's gonna be a mishmash of different paint mixes. And that's typically what I like from the leftover paintings, you don't always know what you get. As always, I start by spraying my cups with silicone spray. This will make sure the paint will release more easily from the cups when I flip them on the canvas. Don't forget to wipe them with a paper towel to make sure there's not too much silicone in there. And now I'm just gonna scrape out every last bit of paint that's left over. There isn't really a particular order that I pour the paints in. I always look for the best color combos. I pour in dark next to a light color and then I hope for the best. I'm left with one color that I have a lot of. I will flip the cups and pour the color around the cups so the paint will go underneath it and give a different effect, and then I have enough paint on my canvas. When you're tilting, keep an eye on the canvas. The cells are really small right now and I want them to be bigger, but I don't want them to be wobbly. So I try to zigzag motions and circular motions to make sure the cells keep their shape. I do always look for the right composition. Parts that I really like, I try to enlarge those parts and move off sides that I don't like. But don't tilt too much, because then you overstretch the cells, they might crack when they dry, or when you don't move too much, don't tilt too much, there will be too much paint left on the canvas, which would also result in cracking of the paint when it dries. Overall, I'm liking this painting very much. It's like a galaxy explosion underwater. The last thing I always do is get the burner out and pop the last little bubbles to make sure there's no pinholes when the painting dries. And then I'll show you the reveal video. I didn't really know if I liked it, but you guys voted on Instagram and you did like it. So this one is named Collision, because there's so many beautiful colors in there and they just collide with each other, and that's why I kept it. So in the end, I'll show you a picture with varnish and it looks amazing. There's a lot of metallic glycerin in there. It's really, really beautiful. If you didn't already, please follow me on Instagram, because I post there daily. I also ask you guys for help when I need something, so please follow me there. Also make sure you like this video and subscribe here, because it really helps me. I appreciate it very much. If you ever want to buy any of my paintings, you find it in my Etsy shop. And if you want digital prints, art prints or any other objects, you find it in the other stores. All the links are down below in the description. If you don't want to buy anything but still want to help me, there's a little tip jar down in the description below. It's a sponsor me link to my PayPal. It will really help me because art supplies are sometimes really expensive. Please let me know in the comments below if you like this painting. Do you like the colors together? What do you think it should have been named? I liked Collision. It is really beautiful with all the colors, but I really like your opinion as well. Maybe I should do more colorful paintings, or maybe I should make it more simple. Let me know. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave a like and subscribe. It's much appreciated, and see you in the next video.